Sure.
Yes, sir. If I may just zoom into some particular details lang, kasi we don't know how this is going to happen. Of course, we do presume that the vaccines will be brought in by air. That's the most practical and efficient way of doing it. As soon as they arrive here, planchado na ba yan? Dinadadaan ang customs yan? O hindi na matetenga sa kung saan-saan? May sasalubong na ba dyan? How does it work?
Yeah. Siyempre, kasi may mga sa vaccine cluster natin, nandun naman ang kasama dyan na ang may task group dyan on the logistics, di ba? So, syempre, sila na yung makikipag-ugnayan sa sasalubong, which is everything, no, from customs to everyone there na sasalubong sa airport. And then, dadalhin yan, kasi Pfizer yan, so that's an ultra-cold. Ultra-cold na temperature ang kinakailangan para dyan. So I think the vaccine cluster have already made arrangements with a private company that specializes in that kind of storage and handling, ano. And then from there, it will be rolled out and implemented muna sa mga hospitals natin. Yung COVID referral hospitals ng NCR ang pinaka-target natin, because
so hindi muna Cebu and Davao, sir.
It's something that's being discussed, and the reason why Cebu and Davao is being considered pagdating sa Pfizer is because yung private company and the logistics and the cold storage facilities are available in Metro Cebu and Metro Davao. So it's something that we're talking about. Basta Pfizer ang brand ng vaccine sa pinag-uusapan. Ang laging handa at pwede dyan is NCR, Metro Cebu, and Metro Davao. So ang question now is, with the initial rollout from the COVAX facility ng Pfizer, i-include ba ang Cebu and Davao? So that's something that's being discussed. But definitely NCR, obviously. But Cebu and Davao, kasi kung konti lang yung doses, I don't know, kasi some people in the group are saying, why don't we do in Cebu and Davao para lang masubukan na, ma-testing na doon. Ma-testing na yung preparations ng Cebu and Davao. So again, it's nothing definite as far as Cebu and Davao is concerned, but it's something that's being made part of the conversation.
Mm-hmm. Well, sir, as you said kanina, uunahin yung frontliners dun sa 117,000 doses, and you specified nga Tala, Lung Center, and PGH, among others. I'm wondering lang kasi if you're only talking about the frontliners na mga hospital na ito, or are you also going to include, for example, their direct family members? Because they do come home to those family members, and that would be a big thing for frontliners.
No, based on the list that we saw, or that's being developed by the NITAG and National Immunization Technical Advisory Group, no? Mm. And based on the protocols given to us by the WHO, as recommended by the WHO, it's really basically public and private health frontliners who are active, no? But it does not include family. Hindi kasama ang family doon. Mm-hmm. So, syempre, ang gusto natin i-inoculate those who are actively in the front line. So public and private frontline health workers yan. So kahit sa barangay, down to the barangay, mga barangay health workers, kasama po dyan sa priority list na yan. But it does not include families.